Holy Trinity, one God, the Word made flesh, our life and our salvation.
Amen.
Trusting the goodness and loving kindness of God our Savior, let us confess our sin. God of life,
You promised good news and great joy for all people, and called us to be messengers of your peace. We confess that too often we hoard our joy, our resources, and our security. We nurture conflict and build barriers. We neglect the needs of our neighbors and ignore the groaning of creation.
Have mercy on us.
Where we are self-centered, open our hearts. Where we are reluctant, give us courage. Where we are sinful, restore our trust. Renew us with your grace, and give us again all hope of eternal life in you. Amen.
Hear the good news. We are children of God and heirs of God's promises through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus, you are forgiven and redeemed. Sing with joy, for all the ends of the earth shall know the salvation of our God.
Amen.
They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Great will be his authority, and there shall be endless peace for the throne and dominion of David. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
On the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. You will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of the ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Judah forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Thank you. angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah. This will be for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger."
Thank you.
take off your costumes very quickly and then come back for some conversation. Or if you want to keep your costumes on, that's also totally cool. Our shepherds, and I'm going to tell you to go put your coats down. And angels, you might want to take your wings off. Those might get a little comfortable if you're sitting for a long time. So just grab a seat and maybe let's just move Jesus back a little bit. There we go. Excellent. So I have some things in this bag that I want to show you. Because it makes me think about what we are doing here at Christmas. Do any of you ever go camping? Yeah? What do you like about camping? What do you like about camping? Yeah?
Traveling in the woods.
In the woods, yeah.
Spending the night,
yeah, like you see all the stars and everything. Aiden, what about you?
Not thinking of any responsibilities right now.
No responsibilities. That's an excellent one. How about you? What do you like about camping?
Swimming with my family.
Swimming, that's a good one. What about you? What do you like? Anything?
Thinking about snakes.
Yes. What about snakes? Whoa. You're a brave camper. Eat steak. Thank you for that corrective. Eating steaks, not seeing snakes. Although sometimes you do see a snake when you're out there, right? You do. So I have this backpack, because this backpack, you know, there are a lot of things in Scripture that tell us about who Jesus is and what he did. And obviously today we're celebrating Jesus, right? So we're going to take a few minutes and think about all of the different things that Jesus does. But the first thing I want to mention, and this is why camping made me think about it, is because, so you know, we heard the story that you all told, which was wonderful, about Jesus being born in the manger. There is another story about Jesus that is not about the manger, and there's no shepherds, and there's no magi. It's in the Gospel of John, and we're going to hear it at the end of our service today when we have our candles and everything. And there's a line, it says, about how Jesus was born first, before anything, that all of us and everything that came to be through Jesus Christ. And it talks about how in Jesus, God pitched a tent with us. That is what the actual word in Greek means in the Gospel of John, about what God did when God was born as Jesus Christ, that God pitched a tent. So, I've got my tent. Do you think that God needed a tent like this?
No.
But it kind of is an interesting way of thinking about it, right? Like when you have a tent, you're moving around. Jesus moved around, right? So that's one thing. Makes me think about that story. The other thing I've got, does anybody know what this is?
A pot.
It is something that you use a pot with. Yes, Amy, shout out.
It makes fire that way.
That's right, it's a fuel canister. So you put a stove on here, right? So is there a way in which Jesus feeds us? Yes. Did Jesus do that in Scripture? Yeah, he fed his people, right? So we've got our stove. That's another thing to think about Jesus. I've got my cup. Did Jesus ever say anything? I think he said something about living water in one of the gospel stories where a woman met him at a well and he said, I will give you living water. Macy. That's okay. So that's another thing. And what else do I have in here? Oh, first aid kit. You gotta have a first aid kit, right? In case you see one of those snakes. In case you get in trouble, right? Yeah, hopefully not. So Jesus also helps heal us, right? What else do I have in here? Oh, tent stakes. Do you think Jesus needed, God needed tent stakes? Actually, no. Those were just mine. And this one is a little silly. I've got soap. So this, although it is not exactly a one-to-one explanation, this kind of makes me think a little bit about baptism, right? Because there's a way that we're kind of taking a bath when we're baptized, right? So that's another thing. And then I've got sleeping bag. Jesus, keep us warm. Safe? Does Jesus keep us safe? Yeah? Isn't that the most wonderful feeling when you're camping and it's a little chilly outside and you're snuggled into your sleeping bag and you feel so warm and safe? Yeah, that's definitely a wonderful moment. Oh, and here's some food, coffee, oatmeal. So I've got all of these things that make me think about Jesus, and I've got something for you as well. So you guys can remember that Jesus is the light of the world. And at the end of the service, we're going to turn off the lights, and you can light your flashlights. And we'll also have some candles, and we'll be able to see how Jesus is the light of the world for all of us. Sound good? All right, I'm going to ask Mary, can you help pass these out? All right. And then after you get your flashlight, you guys can go and take your seats. Thank you for coming up and hanging out with me. You will get one too. She's got them right there in the basket.
Our neighbors, and the world God loves. Glory to you, God, for the song of the angels, proclaiming to the world Christ's holy birth. Give your church a joyful song to sing, that we bring the good news of peace and salvation to all people. Hear us, O God. Glory to you, God, for the stars that shine in the depths of the night. Provoke awe in our hearts at the expansive mystery of the cosmos. Open us to find beauty in the clear darkness of night and in the first glimmers of dawn. Hear us, O God. Glory to you, God, for the child born to us who establishes a kingdom of justice and righteousness. Break bonds of oppression, bring reconciliation to warring lands, and establish peace from this time onward and forevermore. Hear us, O God. Glory to you, God, for Mary's loving care. Lead us to tend to one another in time of need. Share the comfort of your presence with all people tonight who are alone or separated from loved ones due to estrangement, incarceration, or illness. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for the faithfulness of the shepherds in their vocation. Grant rest to any who feel exhausted from their work during this season, nonprofit, retail and restaurant workers, church musicians, administrative staff, and clergy. Hear us, O God. Glory to you, God, for the multitude of the heavenly host. We rejoice in the zeal of all your saints who have witnessed the appearing of your grace and who reveal to us your salvation for all. Hear us, O God.
Abide with us, O God of mercy, and receive our prayers according to your abundant grace.
Amen.
Please be seated. If there are any other folks in the congregation who did not come up for the children's sermon and would like to have a flashlight, you can absolutely get one of those after church. You'll find the rest of our holiday worship schedule in your bulletin. We'll be back here at 9 p.m. and then tomorrow at 10 a.m. at Old St. Luke's Church, just down the road on the Scott Township line. We're having a combined service with St. Paul's Mount Lebanon. I'm going to be preaching, and there's going to be a mix of Episcopal and Lutheran prayers. We sign in on the red attendance pads every time for worship. Please leave us your information, especially if you're a newcomer. You'll find those scattered through the pews. Finally, we share communion as part of worship every week. We use real bread and real wine. Gluten-free wafers and grape juice are available. If you prefer to receive a blessing, cross your arms over your chest. As you come up, you'll receive bread or a wafer from me, and then move to your left or right to our altar servers for wine or juice. Everyone who's baptized from any tradition is welcome to receive. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
has done to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of our faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to love the God whom we cannot see. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you. born to us in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Peace upon your hearts now and forever.
Amen. Amen.